Why do the women love this community?
Like this community because the ladies have their rights.
In Kenya, there is a village where men are not allowed. It is prohibited for any man to enter this village. It only belongs to women. The women in this village build their own houses, raise and educate their children, graze their cattle, tend their garden, do handcrafts to generate them income, all without the help of men. One would wonder why these women would choose to live their lives without men. I was as curious as you are, so I decided to visit them in their village to find out why. So today we're going to know their story and get to the bottom of it. Together with my two friends, we left Nairobi and headed for Samburu land in northern Kenya. We spent a night in Meru and arrived in Samburu at about 10 a.m. the following morning. We headed straight to Umoja village where the women welcomed us with traditional songs and dances in their local language. I was amused by their unique way of dressing, wearing big necklaces around their necks as they danced, sang and ululated while shaking their heads and chests. Thank you for welcoming us at Umoja. What's your name?
Sitian.
So what is Umoja village about?
Umoja village is a place for women only.
Women only?
Yeah.
No men are allowed here?
Yeah.
This group of women created this village as a safe space for women and girls who run away from domestic violence, early child marriages, and female genital mutilation, known as FGM. In Samburu culture, girls are circumcised, which is FGM, as early as 12 years old, and then married off usually to an older man. This group of women have come together to stand against such barbaric practices that abuse their rights as women, and that's why they call their village Umoja, which means unity.
It is a shelter for all ladies who have the same problem, who divorce from the husband, or even those who ran away from the FGM. So they were coming here and found the houses is normally ready.
So meaning you build houses for any woman who runs away, they can easily come and start staying here?
Yeah.
And you give them free housing?
Yeah. Samburu girls, when they reach 12 years, they do the circumcision.
So do people still practice FGM here?
Those one who live far away from the town, they're still doing it.
In Samburu culture?
Yeah.
So I asked Sitian why everyone was wearing colorful beads, and this is what she had to say.
Like this one, it is normally they were being married. And also the young ladies, they are having to put themselves the more colors because they want to decorate themselves. So the old one, they have little bits because the time their children married. So they give one by one to the children.
So for you, why are you wearing big bits?
So because I have married at the earlier time and I'm still young. So I put more to decorate myself.
So yeah. You left your marriage to join the village?
Yeah.
Oh, so now you're single, you're no longer married?
Yeah.
And how old were you when you got married?
I was in 18 years.
18 years.
Yeah.
And how old are you now?
25. Yeah. So that one we use as a ceremonial time. When someone be married, so they put on this one. And now your marriage is so complete. Without that one, your marriage, it is not complete.
So why do you value beads so much in your culture?
Because it is our tradition, no? We're using that one. We don't use the cloth to cover ourselves, so we cover this our breast with that one. Yeah.
The main economic activity of the women is tourism, and in addition to that, selling necklaces and other accessories that they make out of these colorful beads.
We teach each other how to make the beads, so each one they can depend on behalf.
What is she making right now?
The pad for the smartphone. So they close this side. Mm-hmm. And also this side, so they put inside the phone. Mm-hmm. And cover it like this.
So how much is that one?
It is 5,000.
5,000 Kenya shillings?
Yeah. When we get our visitors and came and support us from our market, so something that we get, we divide it into two. So we put to the bank and the others we using it. But the money that we put to the bank, it is helping us to pay for the security, those one who cook food for the children in school, and also it helps us for the health.
So are the women the ones who build these houses?
We build our houses in a group.
In a group?
Yeah.
You don't call men to help you?
No. Ladies only make the house.
Next, we are going to take a tour inside the Manyata.
Samburu houses, we have two rooms. The big one, it is the for the visitors and the children. Here is a sitting room. We stay together and teach each other how to make this one. And also we teach our sons, so they don't do the same as our dad. They grow up, they can be a good men for their wives. So we put the milk here. Sometimes we don't have enough food to feed the children, so we get even the blood from cows. We mix it together. And we mix it with a lot of milk, so they can't see the red color because they fear it.
So is the blood healthy?
Yeah. But when you put the milk, it is light.
I asked the women how the men feel about them isolating themselves, and this is what they had to say.
The first time, they were coming, but at least now our boys is grown up, so they were now our security.
Oh, so now the men around the community protect you?
Yeah, our brothers.
Oh, your brothers,
yeah.
Not the husbands?
No, our brothers. They were now grown up, so they were now our security. Rebecca put for us the modern door, because the first time the men came and disturbed the ladies when they were inside. We can close inside, and we were now safe. They call to each other. Some they have phones. They came together and beating the men or the enemy. So that's why we called our manyata umoja, and umoja means unity. So we do work together as a group.
As the world suffered a meltdown because of the Rona, their main economic activity, which is tourism, came crumbling, and they had to think of a way to survive.
Corona's closed everything, so we don't even get the visitors who came and visit us.
Wow.
So we decided to make the remembrance work. We planted the beans and also greens. But now we see that our country is so hot.
Yes, it's very
and
hot.
Also we're still using the salt water. We plant the tomatoes and also the onion and watermelon. Only watermelon can survive in this country. Greens, they are skuma spinach, we're just trying it.
How are you?
Hi.
What's your name?
My name is Aida.
What languages do you speak?
Swahili.
Swahili.
English.
Samburu. And English.
The women also have a nursery school where they teach their children how to read, write, and sing songs.
It's a baby class, and they teach them both two languages, Swahili, English, but it's a library.
So you have some books to read?
Yeah, we have some story books inside here.
This one? Uh-huh.
Chini kwa chini. Mwakazi Fitness took them through a workout session which they really, really enjoyed, and most of them were laughing and screaming and really, really happy to stretch and do some exercise. We also bought some biscuits and soft drink for the little ones to cheer them up, because you know little ones love sweet things. We spent a full day with the women in their village. I enjoyed every bit of it, but I couldn't stop wondering why their country is so dry and the land barren. As we headed back to Nairobi, I couldn't stop thinking about them. I hope to visit them again in the future. Subscribe, share, like if you enjoyed the video, and drop a comment, and I'll see you guys on the next one. Bye-bye.